Hi, this is Helge, Alexy from the Cardiology Forum, and today I present you a case that I called COVID-19 kills through the back door. And this is one of those cases where the problem occurs that the patient is coming way too late to the emergency department because the patients are afraid at these times of the COVID-19 pandemic to show up at the emergency department, the hospitals, because they're afraid of getting infected with the virus. And this was a 70-year-old male who had chest pain since 4 days already, and saw his general practitioner who treated his symptoms as a gastritis, but advised the patient to go to the emergency department if the symptoms would persist. And indeed, the symptoms did persist, but as I already mentioned, the patient was afraid of presenting at the hospital due to the COVID-19 pandemic. And up to now, he had no remarkable medical history and was now coming to the hospital because the pain has exaggerated and he couldn't stand the pain at home. So at the presentation, he had still ongoing chest pain. He had significant ST elevation in leads 2, 3 and AVF. And after that, he was immediately transferred to the cath lab. Sorry, I don't have his initial ECG, but on this cath lab monitor screenshot, you can appreciate his ST elevation in lead 2 and lead 3, as well as the hemodynamics and the cardiogenic shock the patient was already in, with an elevated heart rate, bad blood pressure of 80 over 40, still ongoing chest pain, but a still conscious patient. And this was his coronary angiogram. Well, we started the angiogram with a shot on the RCA because of the significant ST elevation in lead 2, 3 and AVF. We suspected the ischemia going on in the RCA territory. And what you see here is a good-sized vessel with a branch over here. And then there's nothing coming where you would suspect the RCA going down here. And to confirm that, we did an RCA projection, and this projection, you would suspect the RCA going down here. Well, RDP and RPLD here, but the only thing you see is this vessel here, and this is not the RDP, and this is not the RPLD. This is simply an RV branch here. This here is the first wire in the RV branch, and you can see I already penetrated with this wire one or two times the real RCA and gained some flow again there. Then I did some predilatation. We already had a Timmy flow now in the RCA. Some more dilatations and implanting of a stent. And after that, we gained a very patent and Timmy 3 flow RCA. The patient was immediately better with his chest pain, and the ST elevation were regredient. And this is the final result. Very big RCA. And this is the RV branch from the beginning. And the vessel was closed over here. Well, after that, we turned to the left side and took some shots there. And there we had a problem as well. You can appreciate this tight stenosis in the LID here. And in another projection, very nasty, 99% stenosis in the LAD over here. So I began by wiring the LAD. It was easy to do. After that, I did some predilatations, and what you see here is the stent implantation already. And after that, you see a good result, but some residual stenosis over here in the distal part that was not stented. So I fixed that by implanting another stent and protruding just a little bit in the proximal stent, And after that, we had a good result on the LAD again and a complete revascularization of the patient. And after that, he went to the ICU with a much better hemodynamics and much better clinical symptoms. So everyone was happy. We had the feeling that we would have done a good job and well done. But afterwards at the ICU, I got a call that the patient had a lactate rise of 3 to 5 to 7, despite a complete revascularization, despite an adequate volume status, and the blood pressure falls. The colleagues on the ICU had to start the vasopressors. And the patient was completely free from angina and conscious, but very sleepy. So I decided to perform an immediate echo, especially to rule out a pericardial effusion. But what I saw was the following on the echo. In this personal lung ST, you don't see any pathologies, but when we tilted the probe and went to the personal short axis view, you see this pathology over here. What is this? This is a ventricular septal defect with a huge defect in the basal part of the septum. And this is a typical infarct-related complication after 2 to 4 days after the onset of myocardial infarctions. And this is exactly what was happening here. The patient had his chest pain starting 4 days ago, and he came to the clinic because he had a septal defect at home, and this is why his symptoms exaggerated, and he came to the hospital despite his fear of the COVID-19 pandemic. But at that point it was already too late because the complication had already happened. Well, when we saw the defect in the apical four chamber view, I tilted the probe a little bit, and here I can show you how huge this ventricular septal defect is getting, and I'm trying to measure it for you. And at this point we have a septal defect of about 4.5 centimeters. So this is a very significant septal defect. And you can also see the communication between the left and the right ventricle and the color Doppler. After that, I also performed a TOE where you can appreciate the septal defect as well. And in the color Doppler, you see the communication of the both ventricles as well. And here you see some tissue flapping around in the septal defect, some myocardium and the defect area. Well, how was the further course of this patient after that? Well, up to this moment, the patient was still stable under low-dose vasopressors. And after that, he was admitted to a center with cardiothoracic surgery to discuss this case in a heart team if there is a chance to get this VSD occluded by the surgeons or interventional cardiologists. But after discussing that in a heart team approach, and the patient got their hemodynamical stable but deteriorating, and this is why they put him on ECMO and Impella to stabilize the patient until they could discuss the case. But unfortunately, the patient was turned down by the surgeons as well as the interventional cardiologists because of the size of the septal defect and the lack of options to close that, especially in a case of an infarct related complication, because the tissue is that soft in this case because of the necrosis that there is no possibility to get devices stuck in there or sutures that could hold a closure device. So the patient sadly deceased some days later. Well, what can we learn from that? COVID-19 pandemic is causing less patients for us interventional cardiologists, but because a lot of these patients are very afraid going to the emergency department and presenting at the hospitals because they fear of getting affected with the COVID-19 virus. And the patient presented at the emergency department when the pain was so exaggerated and his symptoms were so badly that he could not stand the problems at home, and then he had to come, but at this moment it was already too late. Well, thank you for your attention. This is a very sad final result for the patient, but I though wanted to share these impressive images with you, because these are some complications, some infarct related complications that we didn't see that often in the past, but in the last few months we observe these complications a lot more. So is it the same you observe in your hospital and your clinical practice? Let us know that. Thank you for your attention. Thanks for watching. Yours, Dr. Helge Alexy. Bye bye.